Hey guys, it's Ro. Welcome to another Nerdy Nummies. I am so excited because for today's video, we are combining two things that I love, Harry Potter and one of my favorite cookware lines, Le Creuset. A big thank you to Le Creuset for partnering with me to make this video and sending me a bunch of their limited edition Harry Potter items from the collection. I am so excited. I cannot wait to make some theme treats. One of my favorite things about these is the enamel. It prevents like chipping and scratching throughout the years, and they make them in lots of fun colors. They're always usually bright and beautiful. This is now my Harry Potter pot. It's Mr. Potter. And if you're interested in checking out the entire Harry Potter collection, I'll put a link down below. So today we are gonna be making a bunch of fun and Harry Potter themed donuts using Mr. Potter. All right, let's get started. First step to making donuts is we've got to activate our yeast. This is very easy. So in a large mixing bowl, I'm gonna combine, this is 1 packet of active dry yeast, 3 tablespoons of regular sugar, and 3/4 cup of warm milk. Then take a whisk and you're gonna whisk together till well combined and set off to the side. You're gonna set it off to the side for about 10 minutes and allow the yeast mixture to become frothy. Our mixture's looking good. A little foamy, that's what we want. We want that froth. Now we're gonna add some additional ingredients to our yeast mixture. We're gonna add 1/4 teaspoon of almond extract, 2 tablespoons of butter, seeds from 1/2 of a vanilla bean. If you've never used fresh vanilla bean when you're baking, I'm gonna show you how to get them. It's very easy. So in front of me, this is a pretty large vanilla bean, and I'm just gonna place it down on a cutting board right in front of me. So what we're gonna do is you're gonna cut it in half, cut all the way down the center. Once you've cut, you can open it up, and all the little seeds, they kind of look like coffee grounds. So to get them out, you're gonna take your sharp cutting knife, put a little pressure at the top of the bean, and then pull down. You're gonna scrape out all of the fresh vanilla bean. Look at that. And that's what they look like if you've never seen them before. Once you've got your vanilla bean in the mixture, the next thing that we're gonna add are 2 egg yolks. We're not gonna be using the white. I'm just gonna use the jiggle method, jiggling the yolk back and forth and letting the egg whites drop to the bottom of the bowl. And then bloop, I'm gonna do the same thing over here. Now whisk together till well combined. Once mixed, you're just gonna add 1/2 cup of flour to the mixture. I'm gonna mix together. Once that's incorporated, I'm gonna pop this onto the stand mixer with a dough hook. Turn on the stand mixer to a low speed, and we're slowly gonna add in our salt and about 2.5 cups of flour. I'm gonna add in the flour 1/4 cup at a time so that we don't get a big dust cloud, and it will allow it to evenly incorporate into the dough. Let the dough keep mixing in the stand mixer for about 3 to 5 minutes until the dough starts to pull away from the sides of the bowl. That's how you know it's gonna be ready. Once the dough is mixed, you're gonna sprinkle a little bit of flour on the work surface in front of you. Plop the dough out. Now you're gonna knead the dough using your hands. You're gonna use the heel of your hand, and all you're gonna do is push forward with the heel, and then you're gonna pull back and turn, and just keep doing this to your dough. After kneading your dough for a minute, roll it into a ball. Then we're gonna place it into a bowl that's greased with oil and put it in here, and we wanna put it all the way around. So just roll it in the oil so it covers all the sides like so. Now we're gonna let our dough rest. You're just gonna cover the bowl with a clean kitchen cloth, put it to rest, and we're gonna let it rise. You're gonna let it sit for about 1 hour to 2 hours. It really depends on the temperature and humidity of your home. Everywhere you live is different. You want your dough to double in size. 1 to 2 hours, just keep your eye on the dough. Once your dough has rested, we're gonna sprinkle down a little bit of flour again. And here's where we're gonna cut out our donuts. Our dough should be ready. Oh, looking good. I love this. You can just let it flop right out. Roll out the dough about 1/2 inch thick, and we're gonna cut out some shapes. Okay, we need some donuts. I love it. This cookie cutter is a donut cookie cutter. It has a hole in the middle. All right, we're gonna pop this out and hold on to that, and place the donut over onto a baking sheet. I've lined it with a piece of parchment paper. I'll do a couple of these. Here you can cut out any shapes that you'd like. I'm gonna do some traditional donut shapes. Also gonna make a triangle donut and a couple circles to decorate. Don't let your donut holes go to waste. You're gonna take them in your hand, roll into balls and put them right over here onto the baking sheet. Once you've got your donuts cut out, we're gonna let them take a nap. So before we let our dough take a rest for an hour or so, but this time it's only 15 minutes, so it's super fast. It's just a little nap. Have a good snooze, little donuts. I'm gonna let these snooze while I clean up the mess over here. Our donuts have rested, they've taken their little nap, and now it is time to fry them on the stove. I love this part. I myself personally don't have a deep fryer. I always fry my donuts just on the stove. I'm using about 3 inches of oil. I've got a little candy thermometer over here on the side of the pot. I'm heating my oil. We want it to reach 350 degrees. Now that the oil is the right temperature, it's time to fry our donuts. Put a couple of donuts in the pot at a time. You don't want to crowd your pot, and you're gonna cook them a couple minutes on each side until a nice golden brown. Then remove your donut from the hot oil with a slotted spoon or a spider and place onto some paper towels. Our donuts are done, they are smelling delicious, and maybe I've ate a couple of extra donut holes already. And it tastes so good. There's nothing better than a fresh donut. And now it is time for my favorite part. It is time to decorate. We're gonna be decorating each donut to be something special from Harry Potter. And we're gonna start with the Golden Snitch. This looks so cool. I love this. And this is the idea behind the donut hole. So this is actually gonna be in the Snitch, and then it's gonna like be floating in a cloud, like in space. First up to decorating this donut is gonna be covering it in a delicious donut glaze. And if you're interested in the recipe, I'll put it in the description down below. Very easy, just powdered sugar and milk. Then I put a piping bag to make it a little bit easier. So I'm just gonna cut the end, and we're just gonna ice and cover the donut. Just gonna go all the way around, work my way towards the center. Then we're gonna cover the little donut hole with glaze as well. We've got both of them glazed, and now we're gonna place on the sprinkles while they're still a little wet. We've got gold star sprinkles, we've got gold little balls, gold pearls, then we're just gonna stick them on top. Now to make some wings for our golden snitch, I didn't make those out of donut, I'm actually gonna use a little bit of fondant. In front of me on a cutting board, flat surface, just gonna roll out a little bit of fondant, and then I've got this leaf cookie cutter, and I'm gonna cut out the shape of the leaf. The wings are very thin and long, they almost look like a feather. I'm going to cut it in half. Then you can use a knife or a little fondant tool. Just make some little designs in the side to look like wings, like so. We're gonna paint things gold using edible gold luster dust and a little bit of extract. It can be any alcohol, and there's alcohol in like vanilla extract, almond extract. I would suggest almond extract or lemon extract, because both of the extracts are clear, so they're not gonna distort your color. So you just add the luster dust, mix it up with a little paintbrush, and then you're gonna paint it on top of the wings and on top of our donut hole. Look how easy this is. It coats really nicely, it's easy to work with. Then you're gonna head over here to your little donut hole. Wait for your glaze to set so it's hardened just a little bit. Then you can paint right on the top, and look at that great color that comes through. And if you need to, you can do another coat. Then you get this very thin, and it also has a hint of the flavor. So you might get a hint of like lemon zest, or like a little bit of like the almond when you bite into it. That it's so good. It's really light and it's delicious. Once they're painted, you wanna let them dry. I'm just gonna let it hang out and set while I start to decorate some of my other donuts. And don't worry about painting the bottom, because it's gonna sit in the middle of the donut. No one's gonna see it. Here's one that's fully dried. It looks so cool. It looks like metal. It looks just like the Golden Snitch. I've caught it. I've won the house cup for Gryffindor. Yeah, right, I'm probably more Hufflepuff. I don't know actually what I am. But first we've gotta put in our gold wings. So you're just gonna place the wings down like so on the top of your donut, and then boop, put in the ball. And look at that, look how gorgeous. Literally looks like it is floating and flying. I'm gonna catch it in my mouth in just a second. Let me decorate some more donuts first. The next donut that we're decorating is going to look like the birthday cake that Hagrid gave to Harry. We love Hagrid in this house. He may be one of my favorite characters overall from Harry Potter. The other year for Halloween, I even dressed up like Hagrid, and Blueberry Muffin was Fluffy, the three-headed dog. Very easy to decorate, so we've got some pink glaze. It's the same donut glaze as I used before, but I've dyed it pink. We're gonna cover the top of the donut with the pink glaze. After we have covered the top, I'm just gonna give it a minute to set. And if you want it perfectly smooth, you can leave it there. And if you want it to look even more like Harry Potter's birthday cake, even more homemade, you can take a little toothpick and put some lines in it, just like he got it. Just had some little creases in there. Seemed like maybe the cake had a bumpy ride in getting there on a floating motorcycle or whatever. Then using a little bit of royal icing, it's cookie icing, I put a little tip at the end for a little bit more control, number two tip, and we're gonna pipe "Happy Birthday, Harry" right on top. The reason I love this cake is because it's definitely homemade. It's a cake made from love, and Hagrid, he can't spell very well, and either can I. I feel a kinship. It's super cute, it's super homemade. Now, let's decorate our next donut. This next donut is super easy. We're gonna decorate to look like Hedwig. I'm using a flat round donut to decorate. I'm gonna cover the whole top with white glaze, but before I do, I'm gonna be adding two little jelly beans for the owl's ear tuft. And you're thinking, Ro, what's an ear tuft? And I don't really know. I'm not a zoologist. I don't know the anatomy, but it's right on the ear of, like, for owls. It makes it look almost like ears, but it's a, you guys get it. So I'm gonna stick these two little jelly beans at the top to be the ear tuft. And I'm gonna use a little bit of icing to get it to stick, like edible glue, just like that. Now this is a detail you can skip if you want to, but I just love those little ear tufts. They're so cute. Then cover the whole top of the donut with white glaze. Then place on little sandwich cookies for the eyes and chocolate candies for the pupils. Also, we're gonna cut one of those candies in half and place it in the middle for the beak. Last but not least, we're gonna decorate using a brown cookie icing. Again, I'm using a cookie icing, not a glaze icing, and I'm using a tip at the end for a little bit more control. I'm gonna pipe on the feathers on the sides. And here she is, Hedwig! The next donuts we're decorating to look like some of the candies that I love seeing in Harry Potter. One are those little jelly beans, Fruity Bots, and the jelly beans are all sorts of flavors. Not just delicious flavors, but also some gross flavors. And also, there's candy slugs. For when they do the spell, eat slugs, you can put them all over your donut. So these treats are delicious and spooky all at the same time. Again, I've dyed the donut glaze this really pretty green color. So you're just gonna cover both donuts with this glaze. And then I put a little bit of white cookie icing in another bag with a tip at the end. And I'm just gonna make some spiral designs on the top. Once I'm done with those, I'm just gonna add some star gold sprinkles and a bunch of the little Harry Potter candy. All right, now we've got an Eat Slugs donut and Birdie Bot's Beans donut. I love this because you never know if your bite is gonna be super yummy or you're gonna get a weird flavor in there. Now we're gonna move on to decorating our last donut, the triangle. The last donut that's shaped like a triangle, we're gonna decorate it to look like the symbol of Deathly Hallows, which is a triangle to represent the invisibility cloak, a circle to represent the resurrection stone, and then a line down the middle to represent the Elder Wand. Usually the bad guys are trying to get all three and, you know, do what they do. To decorate, the icing's really simple. We're using a donut glaze that I've dyed black, covering the whole top of the donut, and then using some white royal icing to make the triangle, the circle, and the line down the middle. And ta-da! There you have it. Here are all the Harry Potter themed donuts that we made today. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. This was so much fun for me. I have not made themed donuts in a while. It seems like it's been a while. And I absolutely love Harry Potter. This was so much fun to do. I'm gonna be posting pictures and the recipes all over my social medias. And if you guys make these, don't forget to use the hashtag NerdyNummies so that I can find it and like it and heart it and favorite it, because I love seeing your baking creations. It just makes me happy. It makes my day. If you enjoyed this recipe video, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, click subscribe, it's free, and ring the bell to receive notifications every time I post a new video. Also, let me know in the comments down below what you would like to see me make next, because I am baking a lot this year. Also, a big thank you to Le Creuset for sponsoring this video. I absolutely love your Harry Potter collection, and I just can't thank you enough for sending me a set. I am in in love with it. And if you guys would like to check it out, I'm gonna put a link down below because it's just super cool. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Bye-bye.